don't go away. Please don't go away.
Hey guys, this is the last video for Upside Down by Jack Johnson. And what we're going to do here is just clean up all the leftover parts. Now, this is all the single note stuff that sounds like this. You know, all that stuff. And I showed you the intro in the first video. Now, so we got that one out of the way. This little lead stuff comes back in two more times. The first time is at a minute 23, and you just saw me play that. And let me just go ahead and show you how to play it. A lot of it's the same as it was before, but a couple of changes that you need to be aware of. First, we're going to start off with the 4 to 6 on the D string, and then 4th fret on the G string, just like we did before, so. And then do it one more time. And then 4, hammer to 6 on the G string, and then 4th fret on the D string. Okay, this is all the same so far. And then 4th fret to 6th fret, you're going to hammer that one, so. And then do it again. And then 4th fret on the D string again. And then 2nd fret. Okay, so that's all the same. Okay, and then you start it over. So 4 to 6 on the D, and then 4th fret on the G, and then again, then 4 to 6 on the G, hammer it, and then 4th fret on the D string, and here's where it changes. Now, slide back here, and I want you to use your 3rd finger to play 4th fret on the A string, and then 2nd fret on the D string, and then play that again and hammer the 4th fret on the D string, and then 2nd fret on the D string. So the ending is only that's the only part that's different from the first time you played it. So all the way through, that one's going to sound like this. Oh, wrong string. Here we go. So that's how you play that at a minute 23. The next time that this actually comes up is further into the song, and this is at the very end. I don't have the exact time down written down, but it's the outro when the song's actually ending, so you probably know what I'm talking about. And it's a little longer. Okay, so starting off, really, we're going to play it the same, but we're not going to play as much. We only go this far. I'm not going to call each fret out because I just showed you this part, but this is how far you play into it. Okay, and then you stop right there. Now, just so you know, this is the part where we're going. We're just strumming the chords slowly, and not playing a rhythm, okay? And you can't do both parts at the same time, so you'll have to pick or have someone else play with you. But that's what's going on, okay? So we played that far. Again, it's just. Okay? And then you're going to play the exact same thing one more time. Now this time you're going to change it a little bit. The first is the same, 4 to 6 on the D string, and then 4th fret on the G string. But now I want you to shift back and use your 3rd finger on the 4th fret of the G string. You're going to play that note and slide it up to the 6th. Okay, then use your middle finger to play 5th fret on the B string. Okay, so. Alright, now. If you can use your pinky, use that one. If you need to switch to your 1st finger and use your 3rd finger, that's fine. But you're going to go 5th fret to 7th fret, and it's going to be a hammer-on. Okay? So, just like that. And then 4th fret to 6th fret on the G string, it's a hammer. Okay? So that last part altogether is. Alright. And it's kind of fading out here, but I'll add a little bit to it. It's going to be 4th fret to 7th fret on the skinny E string, and you're going to play the 4th and hammer on to the 7th, and then pull back off to the 4th. Okay, and then it's right after that, it's 7th fret on the B string. Okay, and then on the B string, you're going to go 5 to 7, it's a hammer, and then 5th fret, and then 6th fret on the G, and then back to 5th fret on the B. It's kind of hard to hear those notes because they're fading out, at least on my version. And so I'm pretty sure that's what they're playing, though. It's pretty easy to hear up until that point. I can't really hear what they're playing after that. So all that together is gonna be this. Okay. And then you wait and you do it again. Third time where it changes. Okay, and then you wait for this last part. And then it's just kind of fading out. So that's basically everything. You've got the whole song now. So remember that there's going to be a video after this. And all it is me playing with the entire song. Now, I'm not doing the lead stuff, but I'm doing all rhythm from the very beginning of the song to the end. So if you want to practice along with me, you can see where I'm making my chord changes and how I'm doing my rhythm, and that might help you play through the song better. So practice along with that if you want to. I am doing it at full speed, but at least you can see the chord changes in my left hand.